Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome to in this video tutorial. So in past couple of sessions we had discussed about the Spring Bean factory container. So Spring Bean factory container is the simplest container provided by the basic support for dependency injections. The bean factory is usually preferred where the resources are limited, like you have a mobile devices or applet based applications. So use an application context unless you have a good reason for not doing so. So if your application demands some enterprise features like support for internationalization, that is also called IATN, or your application if you want to publish some events or you want to implement some MVC kind of application, then this kind of advanced feature is not supported by the bean factory. In that case you will have to use application context container. So we can say that this application context container adds more enterprise specific functionality, such as ability to resolve textual messages, that is nothing but the internationalization, from a properties file, and ability to publish application events to interested event listeners. This container is defined by the application context interface. The application context container includes all the functionality of bean factory container, so it is generally recommended over the bean factory. Bean factory can still be used for the lightweight application like mobile devices or applet based application where data volume and speed is significant. Application context is an interface, so you cannot create object for application context. So there are three implementer class of application context interface. First is the class path XML application context. This container loads the definition of beans from an XML file. Container will loop bean configuration XML file in your class path. Second implementer of application context is the file system XML application context. This container loads the definition of beans from an XML file. Here you need to provide the full or relative path of your XML bean configuration file to the constructor of this class. Now, third implementer of this interface is Web XML application context. This container loads the XML file with definition of all the beans from within the web application. A sample code for application context initialization will look like this. Suppose if you use this class, then you will have to write application context equal to new class path XML application context, and this is your beans.xml is your Spring configuration file where we are going to configure all beans, Spring beans. So this is all about the application context container. So let's go ahead and create one example in Eclipse. So here I'm going to create a Java project called Spring Application Context Demo. Next, finish. Right click on this project, build path, configure build path, add library, user library, and already we have defined a Spring user library. Now let me edit this one. So edit JRE and select default JRE from workspace. Okay, now right click over here on SRC, click create one class is called package.com.infotech.xml dot model. Here I'm going to create a class with name employee. Integer employee ID. So this is just a Pojo class which has two private fields, and I'm going to create corresponding public setter getter methods. Okay, now let's create a XML file. So right click, others, XML. So here I'm going to give the file name application context. You can give the any name as per your convenience. So this is our XML file. I'm going to copy XML doc from existing example. Now I'm going to configure my bin. So we'll have to configure bin id equal to employee and class equal to qualified name of your spring bin class, and your bin class contains two properties, so we need to initialize this property as well. So property name equal to employee ID and value equal to suppose 19901, and next property we have a employee name and value, so Murphy. Okay, so we have configured our bin here. Now let's create a client program. So right click over here, class com.infotech, sorry, dot client. So let's give the class name client test. This client I'm going to put a main method. So here, so I'm going to create application context container. So this is the application context equal to new class path XML. So you can see a lot of constructor of class path XML application context. So I'm going to use this constructor. Here I'm going to pass this XML name which I have kept in src folder. Okay, now we got our application context container. Now we can get the bin. Get bin. So I'm going to use this API, which takes first as the bin ID, which is nothing but your employee is the bin ID, and this is the your bin class. So here you don't require typecasting, so we get the this was supposed to return us employee. references, Java compiler, save and itself. Why this guy is telling me to typecast? Okay, no problem, typecast it. Now we can print the object state over here. So get employee ID. Finally, you need to close this application context. So application context does not have close method. So abstract application context is an abstract class which implements this interface. So of course you can call method which is available in the abstract application context. So in that case we need to typecast application context object. So this is the way to create application context. Great. So we got the output. So guys, this is the one of the way to create application context. As I discussed with you, class path XML application context is the one of the implementer of application context. So you can make use of the class path XML application context to create application context container. Now so next tutorial we'll see how to create application context using file system XML application context. So that's all I have in this video, guys. So see you in next tutorial. Thanks. Bye.